Hello, children. Today I'm going to be reading you a book called Mike Mulligan and His Steam Shovel by Virginia Lee Burton. Mike Mulligan had a steam shovel, a beautiful red steam shovel. Her name was Marianne. Mike Mulligan was very proud of Marianne. He always said that she could dig as much in a day as 100 men could dig in a week. But he had never been quite sure that this was true. Picture time.
You should hold it like this.
Hmm?
You should hold it like this.
Like this?
Yeah. Like that, yeah.
Okay.
No, read!
Mike Mulligan. Mike Mulligan and Marianne had been digging together for years and years. Mike Mulligan took such good care of Marianne.
You're gonna have like story time for the children.
Oh my god.
Continue.
It was Mike Mulligan and Marianne and some others who dug the great canals for the big boats to sail through.
Pictures.
Sure.
I'm vlogging.
It was Mike Mulligan and Marianne and some others who cut through the high mountains so that the trains could go through.
What?
It was Mike Mulligan and Marianne and some others who lowered the hills and straightened the curves to make the long highways for the automobiles.
Pictures! Jared has joined the children.
Burn their brains or something.
No!
It was Mike Mulligan and Marianne and some others who smoothed out the grounds and filled in the holes to make the landing fields for the airplanes.
This is going to be so long.
Oh my gosh.
Keep going.
I haven't even gotten a long page.
I know.
And it was Mike Mulligan and Marianne and some others who dug the deep holes for the cellars of the tall skyscrapers in the big cities. When people used to stop and watch, I can't read. Mike Mulligan and Marianne used to dig a little faster and a little better. Gotta make eye contact here.
Make eye contact.
Staring into the camera. Yo.
Okay, back to reading.
The more people stopped, the faster and better they dug. Some days they would keep as many as 37 trucks busy taking away the dirt they had dug.
Whoa, man. That's a lot of trucks.
Oh, no. Turning point.
Come on.
Then along came the new gasoline shovels, the new electric shovels, and the new diesel took all the jobs away from the steam shovels. Mike Mulligan and Marianne were very sad.
Can I pause here?
What?
So if you're watching this, and you're already 3 minutes into this, so if you are watching this, I am utterly glad. So I thought I'd say that you guys are awesome. So continue.
Are you done?
Yes, I'm done.
Pictures!
Oh, my pictures! Pictures!
Oh, if you want to zoom in there, no steam shovels wanted.
What?
And these are the shovels that are taking the job.
I mean, seriously.
Just thought you should know.
That's like so sad.
Oh no, sad part. All the other steam shovels were just being sold for junk or left out in the old gravel pits to rust and fall apart. Mike loved Marianne. He couldn't do that to her. This is a very emotional part for me too.
So emotional.
Oh, long page. He had taken such good care of her that she could still dig as much as a day. As much in a day as 100 men could dig in a week. At least he thought she could.
Shut up!
You're interrupting story time!
But But he wasn't quite sure.
Just keep going. Don't even listen to him.
Everywhere they went, the new gas shovels and the new electric shovels.
Oh, there's a nude.
And the new diesel motor shovels had all the jobs. No one wanted Mike Mulligan and Marianne anymore.
You read slow.
Shut up.
Hurry up. It's like 5 minutes already.
Okay, you were talking. Oh my god.
Story time.
No!
Then one day, you can't just fuck it.
I gotta take it on the
Mike in the newspapers that the town of Popperville was going to build a new town hall.
Yeah, town hall. Building. Go.
We were going to dig the cellar of that new town hall, said Mike to Marianne. And all his friends. Oh, picture!
Picture! Okay, go. Long words, I mean, it's her.
They left the canals and the railroads and the highways and the airports and the big cities where no one wanted them anymore and went way out into the country. Awesome.
Awesome.
They crawled along slowly up the hills and down the hills until they came to the little town.
You should skip the boring parts.
I am not gonna skip parts. Oh, here's my long page.
Oh my gosh, okay.
When they got there, they found that the select men were just deciding who should dig the cellar for the new town hall. Mike Mulligan spoke to Henry B. Swap, one of the select men. I heard.
Hey, you two. Shut up.
I didn't. Shut up.
You are ruining story time for the children.
You are ruining story time.
I mean, we already have some profanity in here. Don't
talk.
Hey. Today. Go. Just okay. Go.
Marianne and I will dig that cellar for you in just one day. What? Said Henry B. Swap, dig a cellar in a day. It would take 100 men at least a week to dig the cellar for our new town hall. Sure, said Mike, but Marianne could dig as much in a day as 100 men could dig in a week. Though he'd never been quite sure that this was true. Then he added, if we can't do it, you won't have to pay.
Goodbye.
I guess you can continue story time now.
Yeah. Henry B. Swap thought this would be an easy way to get part of the cellar done for nothing, so he smiled in a rather mean way and gave the job of digging the cellar of the new town hall to Mike Mulligan and Marianne. Happy picture!
Yay!
They started early the next morning, just as the sun was coming up. Soon a little boy came along. Do you think you'll finish by tomorrow? Bill, do you think you will finish by sundown? He said to Mike Mulligan. Sure, said Mike, if you stay and watch us. We always work faster and better when someone is watching us. So the little boy stayed to watch.
Aww.
How sweet. Happy time. Then Mrs. McGillicuddy, Henry B. Swap, and the town constable came over to see what was happening, and they stayed to watch. Mike Mulligan and Marianne dug a little faster and a little better. Oh, we're getting to my favorite part. Oh, I skipped it. Picture. Cool. This gave the little boy a good idea. He ran off and told the postman with the morning mail, the telegraph boy on his bicycle, the milkman with his cart and horse, the doctor on his way home, and the farmer and his family coming into town for a day. They all stopped and stayed to watch. That made Mike Mulligan and Marianne dig a little faster and a little better. They finished the first corner neat and square, but the sun was getting higher. Oh, that's not yet. Clang. The fire department arrived. They had seen the smoke and thought there was a fire. And the little boy said, why don't you stay to watch? So the fire department of Popperville stayed to watch Mike Mulligan and Marianne. When they heard the fire engine, the children in the school across the street couldn't keep their eyes on their lessons. The teacher called a long recess and the whole school came out to watch. That made Mike Mulligan and Marianne dig still faster and still better. They finished the second corner, neat and square. But the sun was right up at the top of the sky.
We're running out of time.
Oh, my favorite part. Yay. Because it wouldn't take that long if I were actually doing it.
Yeah, well, just get to the
now
point.
Now, the girl who answers the telephone called up the next two towns of Bangerville and Bopperville and Kipperville and Copperville and told them what was happening in Popperville. I love that part. All the people came to see if Mike Mulligan and his steam shovel could dig the cellar in just one day. The more people came, the faster Mike Mulligan and Marion dug. But they would have to hurry. They were only halfway through and the sun was beginning to go down. They finished the third corner. Neat and square. No picture this time. Shut up, Allie. Never had Mike Mulligan and Marion had so many people to watch them. Never had they dug so fast and so well. And never had the sun seemed to go down so fast. Hurry, Mike Mulligan, hurry, hurry, shouted the little boy. There's not much more time. Dirt was flying everywhere, and the smoke and steam were so thick that the people could hardly see anything. But listen, bing, bang, crash, slam, louder and louder, faster and faster. Faster. That means nothing. Then suddenly, it was quiet. Shh. Slowly, the dirt settled down. The smoke and steam cleared away. And there was the cellar, all finished. Four corners, neat and square. Four walls, straight down. And Mike Mulligan and Marianne at the bottom. And the sun was just going down behind the hill. Hooray, shouted the people. Hooray for Mike Mulligan and his steam shovel. They've dug the cellar in just one day. Suddenly, the little boy said, how are they going to get out? That's right, said Mrs. McGillicuddy to Henry B. Swap. How is he going to get his steam shovel out? Henry B. Swap didn't answer, but he smiled in rather a mean way. Then everybody said, how are they going to get out? Hey, Mike Mulligan, how are you going to get your steam shovel out? Mike Mulligan looked around at the four square walls and four square corners, and he said, we've dug so fast and we've dug so well that we've quite forgotten to leave a way out. Nothing like this had ever happened to Mike Mulligan and Marion before, and they didn't know what to do. Nothing like this had ever happened in Popperville. Everybody started talking at once, and everybody had a different idea, and everybody thought that his idea was the best. They talked and they talked, and they argued and they fought till they were worn out, and still, no one knew how to get Mike Mulligan and Marion out of the cellar they had dug. And Henry B. Swap said, the job isn't finished, because Marianne isn't out of the cellar, so Mike Mulligan won't get paid. And he smiled again, in a rather mean way. Now the little boy, who had been keeping very quiet, had another good idea. He said, why couldn't we leave Marianne in the cellar and build the new town hall above her? Let her be the furnace for the new town hall. And let Mike Mulligan be the janitor. Then he wouldn't have to buy a new furnace, and we could pay Mike Mulligan for digging the cellar in just one day. Why not, said Henry B. Swap, and smiled in a way that was not quite so mean. Why not, said Mrs. McGillicuddy, skipping that. So they found the ladder and climbed down to the cellar to ask Mike Mulligan and Marianne. Why not, said Mike Mulligan. And so it was decided, and everybody was happy. Happy face!
Happy!
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 Yeah. They built the new town hall right over Mike Mulligan and Marianne. It was finished before winter. Every day, the little boy goes over to see Mike Mulligan and Marianne, and Mrs. McGillicuddy takes him nice hot apple pies. As for Henry B. Swap, he spends most of his time in the cellar of the new town hall listening to the stories that Mike Mulligan has to tell and smiling in a way that isn't mean at all. That went in my mouth. Now, when you go to Popperville, be sure to go down in the cellar of the new town hall. There they'll be. Mike Mulligan and Marianne, Mike in his rocking chair smoking his pipe, and Marianne beside him, warming up the meetings in the new town.
Yay!
That took forever, dude.
It did take forever, and so I'm going to be quick, and I'm going to say bye, people, and I hope you all had a great day.
And I'm sorry for taking forever, and probably wasting your time. So,
bye-bye. You want to do the honors? Do you want to do the honors?
Do the honors what?
Doing this. Oh, you don't get the honors anymore.